that lets us come in here and we can just do the back cleanup and have fun with all you guys. So thank you, Carlos.
You're welcome, Tom.
You're welcome, Charlie.
You kind of
all we have to do is show up. He did all the hard stuff.
After we finish the read, we're gonna have a little fun with famous movie quotes in different characters, not just from Rocko's Modern Life. Maybe you can suggest one. I'll go out there from the microphone, and you guys will have the movie quotes with you, and they'll read them off, and you can give one to me, and I'll do it in a character that they want. But for now,
we're going to do some cues and some A's.
We're going to do some cues followed by some A's. We're not just going to do cues and go, you know what, we're not going to answer that.
No problem at this time.
So, without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to present to you a live table reading, unrehearsed, the season 1, number 10 episode of Cabin Fever, ladies and gentlemen. Cabin Fever. Are you ready?
Carlos, when was the last time you read this script?
1947.
When did we do this? What century?
When I had two healthy kidneys.
Can you have around your eyelids?
You don't have two kidneys, do you? I think you only have one.
You still have eyelids, Charlie. Go on, get
one. So, ladies and gentlemen, we take you now to season 1, Rocko's Modern Life, Cabin Fever. We open on a traffic jam on a highway.
Come on!
Leading up to the mountains, cars honking. Mr. and Mrs. Bighead are driving in their car.
Oh, man, this mountain cabin sounds so romantic.
Just you and me, then? Just you
and me. Dissolve to Rocko and Hef in their car.
Just you and me, Hef.
Both cars are headed up the same mountain road in the middle of winter.
Wow, an entire weekend in a mountain cabin. Hot chocolate, popcorn, hot-buttered pancakes.
Oh, yes, there's cool, clean air and no idiot neighbors.
Waffles, sizzling sausage, and
green fruit. Both cars simultaneously arrive at the top of the mountain cabin, but they can't see each other. Rocko goes to open the door. Ed opens the door on the other side. Ed and Bev see Rocko and Hef.
What are you doing here in my cabin?
Look, we rented it for the weekend.
That's impossible. I rented this cabin. It's just right here. One weekend, Big Head's July 4th.
Ed shows him a contract.
But Mr. Big Head, it's January.
One more.
It's okay. Hef and I don't mind sharing the cabin with you for the weekend. We can all have a good time. Come on, Hef.
Hef and Rocko go outside. Beverly follows.
Come on,
Ed!
Outside, Hef, Rocko, and Bev are having a snowball fight. Ed is at the window, jealous. Ben is making snow angels.
Ed, come play with me!
Just then, a snowplow buries her in the snow.
If I could just figure out some way to...
Cut to Rocko and Heather building a snowman.
Here we go. You take this one, roll it this way. Oh, this is good, this is fun.
Rocko, where's Mr. Bighead? I thought he was gonna help us.
Oh, he's making a head.
Reveal! Ed is rolling a humongous boulder-sized snowball to a peak directly over Rocko and Heather.
Hey, what is it?
Give him a head!
He pushes the snowball over the peak. The snowball rolls past Rocko and Heather. Hits another mountain like a skateboard ramp and falls directly on top of Ed. Ed is buried by the giant snowboard. A small piece breaks off and rolls down to Heifer and Rocko. It's the perfect size for their snowman.
Oh, thanks, Mr. Bighead.
Mr. Bighead pops his head out of the snowman's body. We come to the next scene where Beverly is sitting anxiously awaiting in the hot tub.
Ed, come in, darling. The mood is fine. 1 minute, my little polyball.
Just then, Ed gets pelted by a snowball. Hef and Rocko are laughing behind a snowdrift.
Hey, I have to go there right in the face. Good show, Hef.
Ed jumps in a bunker and pulls out a Gatling snowball gun to try and pelt Hef and Rocko.
Oh,
sunglasses and punches out his teeth. Cut to exterior small cabin at night. Later that same night, we go inside and hear Rocko and Heifer trying to guess what shadow puppets are on the wall.
I got it.
Ooh, that's a great one, Mrs.Bighead.
I got one.
Okay.
Heifer walks over to make a puppet. He makes a shadow puppet scene of the bear eating Ed head first. Ed, you cut to Ed soaking at a nearby table.
Oh, Ed, darling, this is so much fun. Come on over and show what you can do.
Rocko, Ben, and Heifer beg Mr. Bighead, to come over.
Come on over, Mr. Bighead. Come on, do it.
Okay.
Ed reluctantly goes over. His first shadow puppet is a perfect depiction of Rodin's The Thinker. Bev, Rocko, and Heifer are completely stumped and throw out wild, incorrect guesses.
It's rubbish. It's a piece of garbage. You know, it's a manhole.
It's a waffle iron.
Ed gets frustrated and makes another one. A buck gracefully prancing in slow motion.
Come on, you can get it.
It's a radiator.
Mr. Bighead is visibly upset. And snaps.
Come on, Ben! Get something! Oh, Ed, you did
it. But too late. Ed is already at the door with two suitcases ready to leave.
How can I rest when I have to spend my weekend with those two?
Bennett! This is a very loud echo. It echoes, it starts an avalanche. It buries and freezes Ed right at the front door. The cabin is now buried under several feet of snow. Cut to Ed at the telephone.
Hello? Yeah, I think you're full. We're trapped!
Cut to Rocko and Heifer and Bev on the couch in front of the TV. Ed is panicked while the three of them are watching calmly and sharing a bag of pasture pups.
Oh, he's a delicious.
We see a TV reporter on the screen.
We interrupt this program to bring this Old Town Action News special report.
What is that? What is that?
Folks, I am standing near the avalanche site where it is believed that two toads, a steer, and a wallaby are trapped somewhere beneath the slime. A search party is combing the area for signs of their whereabouts.
We're here!
It doesn't look good, folks. They'll probably starve.
Cut to another program where we hear an announcer say, and now it's time to cook with Chef Buster. Ed is losing it.
Calm down, Ed.
No need to panic. We should just relax and wait for them to rescue us.
Cut to Rocko and Heifer Bev playing poker. Bev is dealing.
All right, boys. Seven cards. Stud, jacks, the better to open, juices the wild, and the best five skins.
Meanwhile, in the background, Ed rips the phone out and brings it over to a makeshift radio comprised of a microwave with an antenna and two spatulas. Ed shoves the phone in the microwave and tries to communicate with the outside world. Cut back over to the poker table.
Meet him and meet, boys.
Hello? Anybody read? Hello? Mayday! It's here. Do you read? Do you read?
Suddenly, Ed gets reception from a fast food guy.
Can I help you, sir?
Yes! Yes! All right. This is Ed Bighead. I'm trapped in a cabin with my wife and two guys. Do you read?
Right, okay. You want two large burger and two fries?
No! We get two guys!
Oh, okay. Yeah, big burger and two large fries. Oh, that'll be $5.99 at the big window. Thank you.
Walks by with a pickaxe and is headed out the front door.
If you sit around and play games, I'm going to get out of this place. Getting out.
Ed goes out and shuts the front door. Back to the poker table. Bev is not worried.
Ed is a big boy. He can take care of himself. Hurry up, fellas.
Meanwhile, later on, cut to a fireplace at night. Heifer is telling a ghost story to a terrified Rocko and Bev.
Oh, please, not so scary.
And there, next to a mangled corpse, you never say that on Nickelodeon.
Would you ever do that?
That's why 90s Nick tunes were better.
The radio mic?
The radio mic? Okay.
So before we do some questions and answers, I thought we might have some fun with either some more Rocko voices like Bloaty and Squirmy or Leon or I'm a Wild Pig or any of the other voices you think Tom and Charlie can do or I do. We will read you some famous movie quotes. So let's go ahead.